I've been working in a shop for about 25 years now, and whenever you're working with other people, it's a problem because what happened to your tools? You know, we work so fast in this industry. It's just what we do, and you lose stuff. You know, somebody else borrows it and he puts it down someplace and it's gone, and then I go nuts when I want to get something done. I find myself like, say, scrounging around for a half an hour to find a pencil just to do some simple thing. So I have some basic demands around the shop, and one of the key things that I've ended up coming up with is my kit. Like, I can't control everything that's going on in the shop because I can't be every place at all times, but I figure at least I can have my own kit so that it's like a Swiss Army knife on steroids. It's got everything in it that I need on a daily basis just to get basic stuff done. And so I'm going to show you what's in this kit. I've had this case the entire time. I think it's made someplace in New York City. And I'm going to go over every little thing that's in here, because there's absolutely nothing in here that doesn't need to be in here for a general purpose thing. There's no extra, it's all, every little last bit of this is important for general take care of stuff and get it done. First one is a flathead screwdriver, the standard size. The next one we've got, and I actually have a piece missing, there's a tiny flathead screwdriver, and I also am supposed to have a Phillips head in here. Then we have a number two Phillips head screwdriver. We have a, I don't know, it's probably a number one Phillips head screwdriver. I have, this is one of my favorite tools, and I've got a bunch of different sizes of them. These are called Unibits. You can go into a piece of plate metal or wood or plastic or anything that you want, and you can either drill a little hole or a big hole. I've got some different sizes of those. These things we use all the time. They're just really universal. I've got an inspection mirror so that I can look around corners and places I can't get to, that telescopes and things. I've got a pair of small vice grips. And by the way, we have at least a couple of, these are also a basic tool that you should have. I've got a couple of large ones. This one is an unusual sort of channel lock that we can grab things like battery terminals and stuff like that with. I always have a set of calipers because this is a basic tool. It seems like something only a machinist would have, but if you need to know a hole size, you need to know a shaft size or anything like that, you need a pair of calipers, a good pair of calipers. We use those daily. And by the way, these all have, this whole thing, this is like a gun. This whole thing is like a gun. It's like, I need to know where it's at all time. That's my job. This is my job. I work and I live with this thing. So it has to, there's a certain order, there's exact type of and quantity of tools in here. This is a mat knife, has a razor blade in it. This is a thing for dealing with snap rings, so you can spread them to get them off of a shaft. We have a good pair of scissors. I love these things. These are for removing fish hooks, and I can get into odd places with it to grab things that I've lost or remove stuff. I've got a couple of punches for poking little pins out. I've got a center punch, a spring-loaded center punch, a magnetic pickup, again, if I've lost things, need to reach something. I've got a glass cutter, standard. And then I've got an assortment of, I've got your basic forceps. I've got some basic tweezers. I've got some tweezers that are spring-loaded so I don't have to clamp down on something to hold them. That's really handy for soldering and things like that. And these things are pretty nifty. These are for forming wire around, making little loops. They've got a special kind of a curved anvil. I've got a saw that is able to cut quite a variety of things, a little miniature hacksaw, basically. And let's see, what else do we have here? That's it for the top leaf. We've got some shears for cutting metal. These are nice compact basic ones. There's all sorts of different duck bills and everything else. I like these. They take care of most things. This tool right here is probably one of the most important in the entire kit, and it's this particular brand. It's called a Nipex, and for some reason they have steel that is harder than anything else that I've ever found. These will cut piano wire. It's one of the complaints that I have. People get a hold of wire cutters and they cut hardened wire or something, and they ruin the tools in minutes. And these ones are almost impossible to ruin. They're for electrical wire or hard wire or whatever. I've got a couple of pencils. I've got a Sharpie. We use Sharpies all the time. We can make marks on metal or plastic. This is if we're cutting something or drilling something, we need to make marks on what we're doing. You use one of these fine point markers. I've got a screw bit for extensions. If I want to use long screws, I can reach into places with that and support it. I've got a cold chisel. These things are also this is something that comes up from time to time. You've got a massive amount of clamping force. You can make little crimps with it, or you can grab a hold of wire for twisting and bending in ways that you can't.
It's not a cutter.
This isn't a cutter. This is a clamp. It's for making little tiny crimps. But you can also use it to grab a hold of things where you really need to. If you need to bend wire and like a piano wire or a really hardened wire, I can exert like tons and tons of force with those little tiny jaws. We've got an X-Acto knife, and then I've got this tool, which is also one of my favorites because I can put all sorts of, this is a screwdriver that I can put inserts in, and it has a bunch of the different ones. In particular, when you get into things like the Torx bits like this, let's see if I got a bigger one that you can see it. These things you run across occasionally, and you need to have a tool to deal with them. So this tool pretty well handles all of them. You don't see them all that often, but when you need to get something apart, like in an automobile in particular, a lot of times you'll run across these bits, and you got to have a tool for them. Otherwise, in here I've got a little silicone grease. I've got an air inflation thing for air compressor. I've got a little dental floss, so it's basically string. I've got spare X-Acto blades. I've got I've got some spare straight razors, and I've got a sharpening stone. Okay, that's the second leaf. Now we get into the big stuff. You got a ball peen hammer, basic. I have two sets of vice grips. Now these things can exert a whole lot of force if you need to grab something with pliers that you really need to hold on to. You can do it with these. You can clamp things. They exert way more force than what you'd be able to get with regular pliers. For general purpose things like plumbing and so on, these channel locks are necessary, and I gotta get after the guys because there's supposed to be a big pair of these in here as well. Again, you need two of these things, like with vice grips and with these things. A lot of times you want to grab a hold of something and twist, you need to have two to make it happen. I always have two of these adjustable wrenches, which are also for the same reason. If you need to you need to grab the bolt on one end, you need to be able to tighten the nut on the other, you've got to have two of them. I've got one big flathead screwdriver. I've got a brass hammer so I can hit things, metal things, without munching the ends. This actually was made from a screwdriver and a piece of brass stock, so it's actually pretty nifty. I've got your basic standard pliers that everybody knows, just one of those, because sometimes you need something that is like needle nose but gets a little bit more pressure. I've got cable cutters. These things will handle bicycle cables, motorcycle cables. I've got a nibbler. This thing I can make square holes with this. If I drill a hole with a drill, I can go in afterwards and square it to make a square hole if I need to do that. I've got a file. I've got a, this is another tool you don't see very often, but given the base, given the size of this tool, like I can actually get under a sink and open a big wrench with it, or a big big nut, like this will handle, for example, one of those nuts on the drain of a kitchen sink, and you won't find many tools that can spread that large and actually be very sturdy and yet fit compactly in a kit. I've got a tape measure. I've got a small flathead screwdriver, sometimes for just reaching into places. These things are another favorite tool. These things you can grab big stuff with. You hook them in there, and you can. It's a vice grip type thing that that clamps down, but you can grab big pipes, big whatever you need to do. And again, I have two of these so that I can, like, basically big plumbing stuff that you'd have to have a pipe wrench that's this big to do the same thing that you can do with one of these. I've got a Widowmaker. You use this in a drill press. I can cut, you know, really big holes with this one tool. It's kind of scary when it starts spinning around fast though. We also have a complete set of Allen wrenches with the ball end hex head wrenches. And this is also like standard whenever we're scratch building something in the shop, we're using these tools.
What's the good thing about the round end?
The round end, by the way, is actually our cameraman who's making that comment, because he knows all our tricks and what we use. This allows you to socket it into a bolt head and actually be off angle and still turn it. If they're straight, sometimes you need a straight one, but most often this does the trick. If you want a straight one, it's for inserting holding the bolt straight when you locate a hole with it. Plumbing, I've got basic electrical tape, and this is the old-fashioned friction tape, which I love because you can. People don't use it that much anymore, but it's nice because it's almost like Velcro. It just, it sticks to itself. It'll hold, you can use it for electrical things, or you can even use it for tying up extension cords and other stuff like that, because you can attach it and reattach it as many times as you want, and it still sticks, but it's not hard to get off. If you use standard electrical tape, it's like... It's kind of nasty to pull it off afterwards. I've got a couple of C-clamps. I've got a box of assorted little hose clamps and spare electrical tape. We use this not just for electrical stuff, but it, in spite of the sticky stuff that I was complaining about, if you need to just hold something together, it's stretchy. It like you can really grip things with it. So not just for electrical stuff. I've got a set of metric Allen wrenches. If you're gonna have any Japanese or European cars, you're gonna have those kinds of bolts. And then I've got a selection of little bits. This is a countersink. These things are things that you don't see all that often, but they're really handy. They're bits that you can chuck into your drill, and you can put sockets on them for bolts. I've got different sizes of those. I've got a selection of taps, and now these are for for basically making a threaded hole. So if you drill the right size hole, you can drive one of these in it, and you've got something like a nut. You've got something you can screw a bolt into. This is another little thing like that's real handy for little socket things. And this one is a carbide cutter that I can chuck into a drill or into an air tool, and that'll cut just about anything. So I keep that handy. Various kinds of, again, Torx bits, spare Torx bits, and then last, I've got I've got a thing for cleaning out little holes. Now, that's my kit, as well as I have, and this is actually pretty important, I've got a thing here which is, it lists all the drill sizes and fractional versus, I guess you call it fractional versus the inch measurement that goes, you know, 0.001 or that kind of thing. I'm not sure what you call that, but when we're drilling things or cutting and measuring things, a lot of times using terms like 3/4 inch or 1/4 inch or something like that, or 1/16 inch, that's not good enough. We deal with inches, but like 0.1 inch or 0.2 inch or like 1/4 inch would be 0.25. So we've got a lot of equivalents there, and in particular, this tells me what size drills I have to use for drilling holes that I need to put threads into. So I come and go from this frequently. Now, this is my basic kit. This is, you know, if I go traveling or something, a lot of times I just take this with me. If I'm doing anything around the house, if I know I have to build or fix anything, I've got this basic kit. I also, however, generally take an electrical kit, because these days most everything's got some kind of electrical thing going on. So I've got a separate thing about the same size that I pull out with that, and I'm going to show you what that is next. So you may have seen my standard tool kit, but this is my electrical kit. I usually go out with both of them. So this thing is just the basics. It's what I need whenever I go out. If there's any question about having to do anything electrical, I've got this kit. It's nothing fancy, but it gets the job done. This is my soldering iron. I like this one because it's got a button that I can heat it up real quick with, so I don't have to sit around and wait. It's a good, reliable, hot tip. I've got solder of this size. This is extra. That doesn't belong there. I've got a bunch of electrical ties. I've got clip leads. These little things allow you to hook things up and test them without soldering or clipping anything, or you know, cutting anything. I don't know what that's doing in there. I've got a lovely little kit full of all these different connectors. I've got spade connectors and loops and forks. I've got a general selection of wire. I've got some electrical tape, usually of different colors, so that I can differentiate between things. I've got a multimeter. Now I like the needle type for a lot of things, because if I hook this up to a motor and I've got some variation going on, I can see with the needle what it's doing. The digital ones are good too, and they have their own strengths and weaknesses or strengths, but push comes to shove, I like the straight up needle one. I've got a bunch of these. Are crucial. You need a selection of these little twist on connectors, that allows you to attach wire really quickly. These things I'm real fond of. They'll strip the end off of a wire really quickly. These days they'll also cut and they'll do that, and so they expose an end of wire. They're only like 10 or 15 bucks. Then I've got cutters for big wire. These are a must if you've ever tried to cut something heavy duty. We've got your standard nippers, and then I've got a variety of little screwdrivers. Oh, these are the basic things that you need for stripping wires by hand. Sometimes you want those, and in particular for crimping down connectors, you need that. And that is about it for this. The only other thing which I gotta complain about to my guys is there's supposed to be a set of very small screwdrivers in here and a few other odds and ends. I've got some things like some tweezers and an inspection mirror. But if you have that, you can usually go in and deal with most stuff. You might want to, if you're doing a lot of stuff with cars, you probably ought to have a selection of little fuses and things. Of course, there's more refined electrical stuff like, resistors and all that kind of thing, but I would generally deal with those in the electrical shop here. If I'm just going out and there's some problem with my car or with house wiring or something, you can figure out most things and fix them with this.